Hello students, I am Syed Yasmin. Welcomes you in the e-learning classes organized by Cambridge Heights School. Today I'll explain you chapter number 2, that is teeth and microbes. In this video, I'll explain you other different kinds of teeth and the structure of tooth. Now, a newborn baby does not have any teeth. The first tooth appears in the first 6 months. Now, a 2 to 3 years of baby has total 20 primary teeth. These primary teeth are also called as milk teeth. But after that, it starts falling out. Now, at the age of 5 to 6 years, when it starts falling out, new teeth appears. These teeth are called as permanent teeth. Today, we'll see the permanent teeth. And how many total permanent teeth are there? 32 permanent teeth. 16 in upper jaw, 16 in lower jaw. So, we'll see the upper jaw. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 incisors. 4 front teeth in the upper jaw known as incisors. Total there are 8 incisors. Now, you can see the sharp pointed teeth, that is canine. 1 and 2. So, total 2 canines in upper jaw. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, there are total 4 premolars in the upper jaw and total 8 premolars. 1, 2, 3. So, there are total 6 molars. Now, what are the different functions of these teeth? If they are having, so they are having specific functions also. Let's see what the incisors are having specific function, then canines, premolars and molars. Incisors are having cutting and biting function. Cutting and biting of a food happens with the help of incisors. Canine, tearing tough foods. Premolars for cracking and chewing. Whereas chewing and grinding is the function of molars. Now it is clear you students, what are the different teeth in the upper jaw? There are total 4 different kinds of teeth, incisors, canine, premolars and molars, and these are the functions of teeth. Now I'll explain you the structure of a tooth. See, here you can see the structure of tooth. See, what I'm drawing is the outer layer of the tooth. Now, the outer layer of the tooth is also called as, the outer covering is also called as enamel. Enamel is the hardest substance in our body. If it is worn out, naturally it cannot be repaired. And under the enamel, we can see dentine. The yellow area what I have marked is dentine. Dentine is less harder than enamel, but it gives protection to the pulp. Now, what is pulp, students? See, these blood vessels and nerve area. See, it's coming outside the root area. This is the nerve. Nerve is coming outside and getting connected to the gums. This is the gum area. Obviously, the tooth lies between the gums. Gums are actually giving the total protection to the tooth. Now, the pulp is getting protection by the dentine. It's having all the blood vessels and nerves. This is the bony area. This is the bony area. Now, I'll explain you once again. This is the enamel. Next layer is our dentine. Third is pulp. And then from the pulp, nerves and the blood vessels are coming outside from the root through a hole and get connected into the gum. Now I'll tell you that what this upper part is called. This upper part up to the gum is called as crown. And from the gum to here, it is called as root. So, crown and root. It is clear, students, the structure of tooth. Please draw this again and again, at least 3 to 4 times in your copy. Practice it regularly. I'll ask some of the questions, solve that. In our next video, we'll see the different kind of microbes. Hope you understand through this diagram. Thank you and have a nice day.